पुरशाला संस्कृतकक्षायां सर्वेषां स्वागतम्। अद्यतन विषयः अस्ति नामपदम्। तत्रापि हलन्तशब्दानां रूपाणि पश्यामः। सो एट द एंड ऑफ दिस लेसन वी विल बी एबल टू लर्न हलन्तशब्दास् देयर फॉर्म्स एंड सम यूसेजेस ऑफ हलन्तशब्दास्। नाउ इफ यू सी द शब्दास् which are given in any Shabdamanjari book or Shabdarupa Sangraha of Vyoma, they can be classified into two types. One set of Shabdas are the Ajanta Shabdaha. The Halanta Shabdaha is the second type. What do we mean by Ajanta Shabdaha? Ajanta Shabdaha, Ach Anta Shabdaha. Ach refers to Swaras. So they will be either अकारांत आकारांत इकारांत उकारांत ऑल दीज काइंड ऑफ अंतास विच आर ओनली स्वरांत शब्दाः। द एंडिंग लेटर ऑफ द प्रातिपदिका विल बी अ स्वर। दोस शब्दास आर कॉल्ड एस अजंत शब्दाः। द नेक्स्ट सेट आर द हलंत शब्दास वेयर द एंडिंग लेटर विल बी अ व्यंजना और अ कॉन्सोनेंट। हलंत शब्दाः, हल रेफर्स टू द Pratyahara in Maheshwara Sutras, which represents all the consonants, Vyanjanani. When people are at the beginner level learning these Shabdas, normally they learn two types of Shabdas inside the Ajanta and Halanta. One is the Sadharana Shabda, the second is the Vishesha Shabda. What do we mean by Sadharana and Vishesha? For example, we have a case where Hari Shabda is Ikaranta Pullinga Hari Shabda. Now all Ikaranta Pullinga will behave like Hari. Akaranta Rama, we have all Akaranta Pullinga will behave like Rama. This is the general understanding which we start learning. However, what happens is there are some special forms in certain Shabdas which require special sutras as per Panini, and therefore the forms are special. They do not exactly run like the traditional Rama and Hari Shabdas. For example, Pati Shabda is not like Hari Shabda. It is not fully declined like Hari Shabda. It is also Ikaranta Pullinga. So such Shabdas come under Vishesha Shabda. With respect to Akaranta, we have a Danta Shabda. Danta, teeth. Now, Danta Shabda, you have one set of forms which are exactly like Rama Shabda, but you have some special forms that from Tritiya Vibhakti, Data, Dadbhyam, Dadbhihi, some special forms are there. Therefore, Danta Shabda gets classified as a Vishesha Shabda. This is a modern classification by modern grammarians, not Paninian classification. The Sadharana and Vishesha is not a Paninian classification. Now, in the Sadharana Shabda, you have Pullinga, Strilinga, Napumsakalinga Shabdas. Same way for Halanta also, we have Sadharana and Vishesha, Pullinga, Strilinga, Napumsakalinga. This is one way of looking at the Shabdas, how they are classified and what type of Shabdas we should learn. The second type of classification of Shabda is based on the type of word. Now, there are Shabdas which are Namapada, proper nouns, common nouns and proper nouns, which are Namapada, say Rama, Hari, Guru. These are Namapada Shabdas. There are certain Shabdas like Sarvanama Shabdas, which we saw, Sarva, Asmad, Yushmad, Tad, Yetad, these kind of Shabdas. Then you have Sankhya Shabdas, which are the numbers, the Shabdas related to numbers. Yekaha balakaha, yekam balakam, yekena balakena, like that. If you have to use the Sankhya along with a noun, then we have to have corresponding Vibhaktis for the Sankhyas also. So those are called as Sankhya Shabdas. Now in Namapada you have Sadharana and Vishesha, which I've already told. In Sadharana you have Ajanta Halanta. Same way in Vishesha you have Ajanta Halanta, further getting classified as Pullinga, Strilinga, Napumsakalinga. Sarvanama Shabdas also, there is no special classification as Sadharana and Vishesha inside Sarvanama. because Sarvanama is a list of list given by Panini. As I said, it about 35 words or 36 words are given, which are called as Sarvanama. In that list, whatever comes is Sarvanama, and some are Halanta Shabda, some are Ajanta Shabda, and you have Pullinga, Stringa, and Pumsakalinga. But you have Asmad and Yushmad, which are Trishulingesha Samana. They are neither Pullinga, Stringa, and Pumsakalinga. They are common in all the three genders. Sankhya Shabdas, you have Ajanta and Halanta. Eka is a Ajanta Shabda. Shash is a Halanta Shabda. Now, this is just for our understanding as to how these Shabdas are classified. Now, today we will be learning Halanta Shabdaha. There is a very important technique of memorizing the Halanta Shabdas, which I thought I should teach you. And it is very easy to actually memorize the Halanta Shabdas. How do we do this, sir? Basically, we look at the pratyas. We have the su aujas pratyas. These pratyas are added to the root to form the namapadam. Therefore, they are called as subantam. In Prathama Vibhakti, we have su aujas, am aujas, tabhyam bhis, nyebhyam bhis, nasibhyam bhis, nas os am, ni os sup. These are the 21 sup pratyas. There were many questions from our participants. What, sir, we are not able to use these pratyas inside Rama Shabda, Hari Shabda and generate the final form. Just direct addition is not possible. We are not getting the final form. Many times we have to struggle to understand the final form from the root. That was exactly right with respect to Ajanta Shabda. But with respect to Halanta Shabda, we have a technique wherein we can use the modified forms of these pratyas and try to guess most of the forms in some shabdas. Again, I would like to state, we will modify these pratyas. We will understand how these pratyas get modified and then use the modified pratyas to generate and guess some of the forms of the shabdas. And it may not be all shabdas, it may be some shabdas. There is some help and some ray of hope in getting to the form of shabdas easily. Now, let us see what are these modified pratyas. Now, when su au jas, they get modified as su au jas. Jas can become aha in most of the cases. Am out shas, shas also becomes aha. Out will become au only. Now, ta gets modified as a, bhyam bhis, bhihi, bhis is bhihi, nye gets modified as a, bhyam bhyas, bhyaha, nasi gets modified as aha, bhyam bhyas, bhyaha, bhyas will get modified as bhyaha, nas will get modified as aha, os will get modified as oho, am, Ni gets modified as E. Os will get modified as Oho. Sup is Sup. Now, I would request every one of you attending this class to pick up your notebook and pencil and write these modified pratyas immediately in the notebook. So, you write the modified pratyas in the brackets. You write these pratyas. Quickly, you can write these pratyas as I tell them. Prathama Vibhakti, Su, Su, Au, Jas, Aha. Next is Sambodhana Prathama Vibhakti, which is the same. Dvitiya Vibhakti, Am, Out, Au, Shas, Aha. Ta, A, Bhyam, Bhis, Bhi. Nye, Ye, Bhyam, Bhyas, Bhyaha. Nasi, Aha, Bhyam, Bhyas, Bhyaha. Nas, Aha, Os, modified as Oho, Aam. Ni, E, Os, Oho, Sup. I hope people have written down in the notebook these modified pratyas. This is an exercise request all of you to do it. You will understand how easily we can arrive at the forms when we do this exercise. Now, as you write these forms, I would like to highlight an important aspect here. How many of these pratyas are ajadi pratyas? What do we mean by ajadi? They have ach letter as the starting letter. How many pratyas have ach or swara or an vowel as a starting letter? Now let us count them. Sa does not have an ach here. Au has got an ach. Au is an ach. It is directly it is a ach varna. Now aha is also starting with a and the visarga is there. So aha can also be treated as a ajadi pratyaya. Am can be treated as an ajadi pratyaya. Ajadi pratyaya refers to that which has vowel at as its starting vowel, starting letter. Out in out, au is an ajadi pratyaya. Shas aha is an ajadi pratyaya. So in the first two vibhaktis, including sambodhana, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Because sambodhana, dvivachana and bahuvachana also we have to add. So 7 out of 24 in the first two vibhaktis. In the tritiya vibhakti, we have a, which is the 8th ajadi pratyaya. Bhyam and bhis start with the letter bha. Therefore, they are not ajadi pratyas. Then you have nye. You have nye in that it is modified as ye. Therefore, it is an ajadi pratyaya. Nasi, you have a. So 8, 9 pratyas over. 10th one is nasi, aha. 11th one is nas, aha. Os is oho. 12th pratyaya. Aam is also an ajadi pratyaya. Shashti bahuvachanam. 13. E is an ajadi pratyaya. 14, 15. Os is a, oho is a ajadi pratyaya. So about 60 to 70% of the shabda can be guessed by these ajadi pratyas. How do we do that, sir? Let us take the example of jalamuch shabda. Chakarantaha pullingaha jalamuch shabdaha. Megha Bhagini, can you repeat?
Chakarantaha pullingaha jalamuch shabdaha.
Jalamuk jalamuchau jalamuchaha.
Jalamuk jalamuchau jalamuchaha.
He jalamuk, he jalamuchau, he jalamuchaha.
He jalamuk, he jalamuchau, he jalamuchaha.
Jalamucham, jalamuchau, jalamuchaha.
Jalamucham, jalamuchau, jalamuchaha.
Jalamucha, jalamugbhyam, jalamugbhihi.
Jalamucha, jalamugbhyam, jalamugbhihi.
Jalamuche, jalamugbhyam, jalamugbhyaha.
Jalamuche, jalamugbhyam, jalamugbhyaha.
Jalamuchaha, jalamugbhyam, jalamugbhyaha.
Jalamuchaha, jalamugbhyam, jalamugbhyaha.
Jalamuchaha, jalamuchoho, jalamucham.
Jalamuchaha, jalamuchoho, jalamucham.
Jalamuchi, jalamuchoho, jalamukshu.
Jalamuchi, jalamuchoho, jalamukshu.
This is the traditional shabda that we learned.